Hello everyone, it's Deborah. Normally right now we'd be having our quarterly open team meetings, but this year, because we are very busy with both our merger with Clinton and Epic, I have opted to do a YouTube video, and hopefully you can watch this at your convenience and squeeze it in. We'll try to be pretty quick here, but I wanted to give you an update on things that are going on and where we are. So it is an exciting time for all of us, and I know how hectic it is when we go to change things, but I wanted to remind us first that change is such a huge opportunity. Whenever you change anything, you have a chance to reinvent what we're doing, and we have a great opportunity to do just that as we look forward into 2018. So we're merging with Clinton, as everyone's aware, and going live on Epic in just a matter of days. So it will be it'll be an exciting 2018. I wanted to also share with you that we've been working hard on changing some of the processes we use from a management level, which is how we manage and how we work together as a team. So recently, we actually completed a leadership standards of cooperation document that we'll make available to everyone. But I think it's important that everyone understand what our expectations are of our leaders. As you leaf through this, you can see what we're asking of them and how they need to be responding to each one of you as well as to each other. So take a minute, look at it when you get a chance, and see and talk to your leader about it in respect to how they're doing in their fulfilling of those expectations. So how are we doing in 2017 before we get too far ahead? Well, we've had our 10 goals that we've been working on, and as you know, we've been tracking them throughout the year. Of our 10 goals, it appears that we will be able to achieve 6 of those objectives. 4 of them, I believe, unfortunately, we probably are not going to make. So the 4 that we're falling short on are the same 4 that we've struggled with all year, which are our mortality measure, our readmission measure, our leadership rounding, and then finally our financial results. We've worked hard on all of these, especially those first 2 quality metrics, in the mortality and the readmissions, but we need to put some more energy around that in future years, and I know you'll hear more about that in very near future. The leadership rounding we fell behind on, this is the first time we've tracked that to this level, and we do need to get out and about and see everyone. That is a criteria also in the leadership standards of cooperation. Finally, under the operating margin, I do want to call your attention to the fact that we are making money. We have made approximately $5.3 million this year, but that unfortunately is behind where we had expected to be. So we're about $700,000 behind our expected goal. This is important because, as we've said in the past, if we don't make money, we can't reinvest our money into things that we need, such as equipment, increases in salaries, and so forth. So although we're a not-for-profit, making money is indeed important for us now and into the future. So those are where we stand right now in our 2017 goals. Right now, as far as 2018, we're working to finalize those goals. Again, they've been delayed just a bit because of the work with Epic, but we plan to actually optimize Epic in 2018. To work to standardize and improve all of our care processes and obviously improve our expanded organization's brand and reputation as we go into the future years. We really want the community to know what Health Alliance-Clinton is going to be able to provide to them and their family as their health needs change over their lifetime. So in terms of feedback for me at this point, if you have any questions or concerns, please reach out to the mergermilestones.org link. Ask any questions that you have, and we will address those. If you want me to personally get back to you, please let me know, and we'll follow up. So leave your name and any comments that you have, and or can be completely anonymous. But I do always welcome your thoughts, questions, and concerns, so please share those. We will be resuming our normal team meetings in November and probably the end of November and early December. So look for those, and I look forward to seeing you in person versus a video. It's much easier to talk to you that way. So please keep me posted on how you're doing. And in just a matter of days, we've become one organization, 163 beds serving our region. And I'm really excited about it. I hope you are too.